And it's time to review the shoe that I wore today. Today is the 20th of October 2014, my day 15. I'm still going strong. My body's getting really tired, to be honest. But we'll talk about that later. It's reviewing the shoe time. And what I wore today was my beaters. Okay, nothing very special, nothing fancy or anything like that. I was actually running late to the gym with an early session today, and this was just in my beater pile. But still one of my favorite beaters of all time, and if I find another pair, I will more likely buy it. And what I wore is the Jordan 1 Fat. Is it Jordan 1 Fat Lows? Black Cement. Okay, obviously look at it. Yeah, it's a beater. Look, it's dirty. It's still good leather though. Like, it's proper tumble leather. It's pretty thin here, but it's thick here. Anyways, that's the shoe I wore. Then my go-to shoes, performance-wise. This could just be me, and this is just my opinion. But they're handled well. They're beaters. So mostly your beater shoes are molded. They're going to be comfy. Your feet know it already. So my feet were not sore. And with Jordan low fat ones, hence the name fat, there's a lot of cushion. So it was comfy when I was doing legs. Low center of gravity, flat, so great for legs. The other thing I don't like, obviously because they're beaters, they look a little bit dirty. And when I went walking after, don't know how I did that. When the toe box, obviously you're bending your feet. It bends too much. But that's just my opinion, okay? Rating. I'm gonna have to give it an 8. It's so comfy. It's low cut. It looks good. It feels great on feet. So it's an 8 for me. Now, with my diet, with my training, my body is getting very tired. I'm finding it harder to wake up to do my cardio in the morning. It doesn't help that I sleep late though, because I'm editing videos or I finish the gym late or whatnot. And doing a challenge, doing this challenge and training every day and whatnot, it's not only taking a toll on me, but it's taking a toll on my family. But all I can say is that they're supporting me really great. I wish I could spend more time with them, because before work in the morning, I'm out at the gym, going for a walk, do whatever. Then again, I have breakfast with them. Then we rush out, they send me to work. When I get home, I rush around at home, go to the gym for like 2 hours, because an hour and a half of training, because normally there's three of us, and then half an hour or 25 minutes of cardio, so it'll equal up to around, say, 2 hours, plus travel time. And then when I get home, it's late. Most of the time, they're really all asleep, I'm eating by myself and whatnot. So it's a big sacrifice, what I'm doing. They're supporting me. And that's why sometimes I drop the ball on the weekend. I train really, really late. Or I try and sneak in and do a small session or whatnot. But like last Saturday, I did a very small shoulder session. I had to do it within an hour. I got family things to do as well. I ain't single. I got a family, I got 2 kids. So obviously responsibilities and whatnot. So just try and plan your day, guys, if you can do something like this, especially when you've got a family. Anyways, that's it for me. Thank you for watching. Thank you for liking. I'm just going to keep pushing and whatnot. Just to let you know, when I hit day 30, so halfway through my challenge, I will probably more likely do some progress shots. So hopefully, with my eyes and your eyes, we could see a change. And if we see a change, then what I'm doing is working. And that's what I really hope, because I don't want to do this and train so hard and eat so clean and diet hard for no results. So I'm doing it obviously to be held accountable, but hopefully this will push me to train hard and whatnot. Anyways, that's enough. Thank you for watching. Give this video a big thumbs up. Like, comment, share, subscribe. That's it. And I must go. 'Cause it's bedtime, nigga. Bye.